Pambansang Museo is located at Eudora F. Valencia Circle, Ermita, Manila City, Metro Manila. Admission to National Museum is permanently free of charge for all visitors, Filipino or foreign, to its museums nationwide. Here are the rules and regulations inside the museum. Backpacks and bags bigger than a short band paper must be deposited at the baggage counter. You cannot bring with you umbrellas, pens, and other markers. You should deposit them at the baggage counter. Food and beverages are not allowed inside the museum. Refrain from wearing caps, hats, or bonnets. Wrapped packages are prohibited. Do not touch nor lean on the museum objects, displays, and exhibits. You can take photos, but you must refrain from using the camera flash. Taking videos is strictly prohibited. Tripods and monopods are not allowed. Disrespectful and rocky poses are not permitted. Do not sit on the floors and no smoking. The National Museum of Natural History. Inside the museum, you'll find art pieces and collections covering botany, geology, and zoology. Some of the most notable attractions in the National Museum of Natural History include the Tree of Life. The architect Dominic Galicia explains the metaphor of the Tree of Life. It is both biblical, mythological, and philosophical. One of the requirements of the project was to make use of the central space created in the inner courtyard. Lolong, the skeleton of the Philippines' largest crocodile. Lolong was the world's largest saltwater crocodile in captivity until his death on February 10, 2013 in Agusan del Sur. He was 6.17 meters long and weighed 1,075 kilograms. The crocodile was named after Palawan crocodile hunter Ernesto Lolong Cognate. Rainforest Diorama and Mangrove Diorama. In Gallery 9, you'll find a life-size diorama of a mangrove forest. This huge installation doesn't just recreate the mangrove ecosystem, but also educates people the importance of such trees in our environment for us and for the animals that use mangroves as their main habitat. Next is the National Museum of Anthropology. It presents exhibits and information on the origins of the Philippine Islands and the Filipinos. The exhibition focuses on the Philippines' four prehistoric periods: Paleolithic, Neolithic, Metal, and Ceramic Age. Here are some of the exhibits in the National Museum of Anthropology. San Diego Exhibit. Gallery 2 is solely dedicated for the massive number of artifacts salvaged from San Diego. San Diego was a Spanish battleship that sunk near Fortune Island in Batangas after it had collided with Mauritius, a Dutch warship. 5 centuries of maritime trade before the arrival of the West. Centuries ago, before the coming of the Spaniards, merchant vessels were already sailing through Southeast Asia, bringing trade and commerce to the Philippine Islands. Some of the vessels were fortunate to cross the seas, but some have sunk either because of natural calamities or pirates have attacked their ships. For a very long time, the remains of these vessels remained underwater until they were discovered by treasure hunters, explorers, and archaeologists. The discovery of these vessels is a concrete evidence of a dynamic trading among peoples in the Southeast Asian region even before the Europeans came. These vessels carried various ceramics and other commodities from China, Vietnam, and Thailand. The Kaban ng Lahi, Archaeological Treasures. This gallery is one of the long-running exhibitions at the National Museum of Anthropology. It was installed in celebration of the centennial of Philippine independence in 1998. This gallery is architecturally designed to simulate a cave setting where most of the burial objects exhibited were discovered. The gallery highlights the past burial traditions and remarkable craftsmanship of past Philippine societies about 1,000 to 2,500 years ago. It features the mortuary pottery from Ayub Cave in Pinolmay Tomb, Sarangani Province, formerly South Cotabato, and a diorama that shows how the burial jars were found arranged inside a cave by archaeologists. The Maitum anthropomorphic burial potteries, which are secondary burial vessels shaped into human figures in various facial expressions, are presented in this exhibit together with the wooden dugout coffins from Banton in Romblon, limestone urns, and a collection of pabaon or associated burial goods. This gallery showcases a number of objects declared as national cultural treasures. The Manunggul Jar, Maitum Anthropomorphic Burial Jar 21, Leta Leta Stem Cup, Leta Leta Footed Jarlet, and Leta Leta Presentation Dish, and Likha. These entities are regarded for their uniqueness and outstanding historical, cultural, artistic, and historical value discovered from different sites in the Philippines. Next is the National Museum of Fine Art. It is among the most visited branches inside the National Museum. This is where you'll find the historic and most famous National Museum paintings in the country. Here are some of the paintings inside the museum. The Old House of Representatives Session Hall. Religious art from the 17th to 19th centuries. Art prints from the archives of Royal Botanical Garden in Madrid. Academic and Romantic Art. Academic and Neoclassical Sculpture. Homage to Dr. Jose Rizal. Classical Art from the 20th Century. Drawings of Fernando Omorzolo and Works of Guillermo Tolentino. Lastly is the National Museum of Planetariums. Its main function is to spread astronomical information through planetarium shows, lectures, demonstrations, exhibits, and actual celestial observation. Its unique feature is through the live showing of astronomical bodies that captures the interest and tickles the imagination of viewers. Indeed, that Philippines has always something to offer. Visit a national museum and be indulged with the culture, history, silhouettes, and symbolism of our country. I am Ella Capiliano. Good day, everyone!